Welcome to the online lecture series of Turbo Machines. Here is Professor Lakshman Mane. This is lecture on impulse turbines part 9, that is governing of impulse turbines. I acknowledge my sincere thanks to the following authors and courtesy for being used these concepts to make this video session. In this session, you will be able to explain what is governing of hydraulic turbines. You will also be able to explain governing mechanism of Pelton wheel. Let us see about flow rate and speed of turbine. So here we observe a jet of water passing on the buckets of Pelton wheel. So, as the flow rate of water is high, speed of turbine is high. So, this regulation of flow to the turbine is done by using spear mechanism. So, let us see in this diagram. This is a spear which is moved in forward and backward direction by using hand wheel, or in case of governing mechanism, it is done automatically. So when this spear is moving in forward direction, it reduces flow area, which reduces flow rate of water passing to the turbine. And when the spear is moved in backward direction, it increases flow area, which increases water flow rate passing to the turbine. So this automatically regulation of speed in the turbine is called as governing of the turbine. Now we will see need of governing, means why the governing is required. When a turbine drives an electrical generator, the basic requirement is that the rotational speed of the shaft or turbine rotor should be fixed. Otherwise, the frequency of the electrical output will be changed. But when the electrical load changes as per the demand, the speed of the turbine changes automatically. For example, when the load is increased, the speed of the turbine decreases, and when the load is decreased, the speed of the turbine increases. Therefore, a constant speed is maintained by adjusting the rate of flow of water to the turbine accordingly. Means, when the load is increased, the flow is increased, and when the load is decreased, the flow is decreased. This adjustment of flow with the load is known as governing of turbines. So, governing of turbines means controlling speed of turbine by regulating the rate of flow of water passing through the turbine. Governing of turbines is done automatically by a device which is called as governor. So, governor regulates the rate of flow according to changing load conditions on the turbine. Now we will see governing of Pelton wheel. So, in Pelton wheel, governing is done by using flyball governor. So here is a diagram of flyball governor. We will see first of all various parts of flyball governor. So here is centrifugal governor with flyball with sleeve. This sleeve is connected to lever and fulcrum mechanism. This lever is connected to piston rod of control valve, which is moving inside this relay. Then here, this is piston rod of relay cylinder, which is connected to the spear. And this is relay cylinder or servo motor. Now, here to move this piston, pressurized oil is required. So for that, this is an oil sump and oil pump. Now, speed of turbine is regulated by the movement of spear at nozzle that already we discussed. So spear movement is controlled by pressurized oil from the pump. So this is a oil pump which provides pressurized oil to the cylinder. So oil flow to the cylinder is directed. So here are two ways. This is a side A and this is side B. So when the valve V2 is open, in that case oil is diverted to the cylinder via V2 port to A side of the cylinder. And when valve V1 is open or port V1 is open, in that case oil is passed via this path to the side B of the cylinder. So here, working of governing using flyball governor has two cases. Case 1, when load on governor decreases. In that case, speed of turbine increases. So centrifugal force on flyball increases, so which moves this sleeve in upward direction. So this movement is passed through the lever and fulcrum to the piston rod of control valve. So by which piston rod of control valve is moving and it is opening port V2 and closing port V1. So oil from the pump is moving through the open port V2 to the A side of relay cylinder, which moves this spear in forward direction. Thus it reduces flow area. Hence water flow rate to the turbine is reduced, and thus speed of the turbine is reduced till that turbine comes to its normal speed. So this is what case 1. Now we will see case 2, when load on governor increases. So in this case, speed of the turbine decreases as the load increases. So with decreasing speed of turbine, centrifugal force on flyball is reduced. So it brings flyball in downward direction, which moves this sleeve in downward direction. So this movement is passed through lever and fulcrum arrangement to piston rod of control valve, by which piston rod of control valve closes valve V2 and opens valve V1. So as valve V1 is open, or port, we say here it has a port. When it is open, then oil from the pump is conveyed via this path to the side B of the cylinder. Thus it moves back this spear. So as spear is moving back, then it is increasing the flow area. When flow area is increased, then automatically water flow rate passing to the turbine is increased, and thus speed of the turbine is increased till turbine comes to its normal speed. So in this way, governing mechanism of Pelton wheel by using flyball governor works. So after this session, You can explain what is governing of hydraulic turbines. You can explain governing mechanism of Pelton wheel. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thank you.